Hello everybody, it is so great to be with all of you today. Today I'm here to give you some information about things that we've been doing recently and things that we will be doing soon. But first of all, I want to give you a quick reminder of how Dataiku can help you solve your data challenges. Now, many of you here are Dataiku users, so this may not be new to you. But we believe that it's interesting to have a look at everything that Dataiku does for you. Every company wants to embrace AI. That's almost now a cliche to say that. But it is still very true that companies still tend to underestimate the challenges of actually embracing data, connecting to so much data, and having so many profiles that will struggle to work together. You will have data engineers who will have to maintain complex and brittle data pipelines. Business analysts who will be stuck with point tools, point solutions that they need to integrate together. Data scientists spending a lot of time doing low value tasks like data preparation using Python or complex scripts. Compliance managers struggling to keep track of all these data initiatives everywhere in the organization. Operations engineers who cannot maintain smooth operations. And most importantly, at the end of the day, business users do not get the data they need in order to work and in order to deliver value. We believe that this is caused by lack of sharing, lack of collaboration in the data lifecycle. And when you add lack of oversight and regulations on the horizon, it leads to a lot of lost value. And this is where Dataiku can help. Because Dataiku is the future-proof platform for all of your data projects. It is excellent at getting data from various data sources. And then it is a complete platform. It is both for coders and non-coders. It is a shared space with coding capabilities, visual capabilities, and now generative AI capabilities, where everything appears in the flow, appears in what is a common grammar between all of these roles. And very importantly, it is a platform that is both for design and production working together. It is designed to minimize friction between the people who design the data products and IT and operations who have to operate them by providing this unified CI/CD compliant architecture. Dataiku is built on top of an architecture that is both, cloud native and cloud agnostic, meaning that it allows you to choose the infrastructure you want, to choose the compute, the storage that you need, and very importantly, it's a versatile architecture that allows you to embrace new technologies, new innovations, like generative AI, foundational models, and keeping your choices open. And the combination of this versatile infrastructure and this complete end-to-end platform leads to a world where data products now become available. Meaning that what you design in Dataiku becomes immediately available, trusted, and usable by your end users, your business analysts, or your applications through APIs, which means that it can create value. With AI regulation on the horizon, both in the United States, in Europe, and in other locations, governance of AI platforms becomes paramount, and it is built in Dataiku. Dataiku is really providing oversight for all your AI portfolio. So that was for the intro. Now, what's interesting is how do we think about what we build in Dataiku? At Dataiku, everything we do is based on these three principles, and this is how we focus our efforts and our development. We want more builders of AI, more people who can build data products. Creating data, creating insights, creating applications is not just for the happy few, it has to be something that is more democratized, and that is one of the core things that Dataiku is here to help you achieve. Even so, skills shortage is still a problem. Probably none of you are bored and you have a lot to do, and everything we can do to make you go faster will allow you to deliver more value quickly. So going faster is again one of the very first things that we focus on. And actually deploy things, meaning having the ability to actually have a trusted environment in which what you have designed can be deployed. So these are really the three pillars of how we think and of how we deliver capabilities in Dataiku. So let's talk about that thing. Oh no, sorry, not that elephant. That elephant. Generative AI. Maybe you've heard about that. Maybe. And to be honest, I think generative AI has created a lot of feelings in us. It is exciting. I mean, it is indeed a revolutionary technology. It is so fun to play with. I guess all of you have played with generative AI this year. And it really feels like magic. And it had been a very long time since technology had felt so magic. But it is also a bit worrying because there is so much change. Do we need to change everything we do? Will our jobs be replaced by generative AI? And at the end of the day, it leaves us a bit lost because it is so overwhelming. There is so much things that change. And if you try to follow generative AI news on Twitter, it's called X, you get lost very quickly. And I have a confession to make. It's the same for me. It is complicated for everybody. It is a fast-moving world. And yes, there are people who say that developers are going to be replaced by generative AI too. Look, I would not mind. I would have more free time. But we do not really believe that this is entirely true. What we believe is that generative AI fundamentally is a tool. It's a tool that enables new possibilities, that enables new applications, that makes things that were impossible or at least unrealistic, possible, realistic, and even fun. And it will replace some of the tools that exist. But still, it is a tool, and a tool is always part of a workshop, and it is one of the tools that you must use to deliver value, but it still has to be integrated with everything you do. Not every application that requires data will be fully generative AI powered, and just generative AI will not create an end-to-end application for your users. So it is a tool that needs to go with others, and this is why you need, for building generative AI applications, a platform. Still, there are a few things, a few recommendations that we can make on how we are seeing success in delivering value through generative AI. The first thing is to start with common application types. There are already several types of applications that are already proven to deliver value with generative AI. And you should really strive to start with these common patterns and move on towards more exotic types of applications later on. And we see several patterns emerge of these kind of applications that deliver value. The first thing is transforming unstructured data into structured data. And really, this is done by replacing a lot of legacy NLP pipelines and capabilities. I guess some of you were maintaining NLP pipelines, and it was not always fun. Generating is taking, okay, you have your analytics project, which could be predictive or not even predictive, and transforming its content, its output, into tailored content, sending automated emails, for example. And finally, it's almost even the most common application type that we see these days, it's answering, transforming your internal documentation, transforming your support repository, transforming every internal knowledge bank that you have into actionable question and answer generative AI powered applications. So that is a bit the what you should probably start by building. Now the question is how? And here again, our recommendation to you is start simple. We see a lot of excitement around the most advanced kind of techniques for generative AI, fine-tuning, reinforcement learning with human feedback, even pre-training, agents, etc. But there is so much value that can be done with more simple techniques. So really, our recommendation is, again, start simple. Just use LLMs and capabilities that Dataiku will make available out of the box, and then move towards more complicated techniques. And this leads us to having this kind of scale of techniques for doing generative AI. And a bit later this morning, you will learn much more about how Dataiku will bring capabilities for each of these levels in the product for you to directly use. But even with these application types, with these techniques, there is still a last challenge. And the last challenge is that we see a significant gap between the exciting and innovative underlying services and infrastructure for generative AI and applications that can be used in the enterprise and that can deliver value. And that gap needs to be fulfilled for generative AI to be adopted in the enterprise and to not have a situation where only at home can you use generative AI, but not at work. And this need is a common backbone for generative AI applications. Because there is so much excitement with these models. There is so much new things coming every day. And this is why today, we are not announcing that we are creating our own Dataiku LLM or our own Dataiku vector stores. This has been our vision and how we have built the Dataiku platform since the beginning of working. We are here to take these core technologies and make them available and truly usable in an enterprise setting. And so, what we are announcing today is a set of features that will make accelerated computing, hosted LLM APIs, self-hosted LLMs, and vector databases truly usable in production, in the enterprise, in your day-to-day. And we call this the LLM mesh. The LLM mesh starts with routing capabilities, meaning the ability to manage several providers for LLMs, for vector stores, but most importantly, the ability to switch between providers. Generative AI is a new world, a fast-moving world, a nascent world in a sense, and it is vital for you to keep your choices open. Now is not yet the time to lock in technical choices. And that's why the LLM mesh allows you to easily switch between providers in order to choose the one that is the most adapted to each task. But it doesn't stop here. We are also including in the LLM mesh a set of capabilities that will allow you to control your costs, to ensure the safety and security of the content that you send to LLMs and the content that you receive from LLMs, the ability to set permissions to control which data can be used with which model. For example, you may have little or less sensitive data for which you may be able to use a third-party API, and that allows you to get started very quickly, whereas for more critical, sensitive, confidential data, you would only use self-hosted LLMs. And the LLM mesh allows you to set up this kind of rules. And it also includes accelerators for common approaches like retrieval augmentation, which allows you to infuse LLMs with your own internal company knowledge. And just in keeping with Dataiku's philosophy, all of these capabilities will be available either through our no-code, low-code UIs, or in a fully coding environment using your preferred IDE. So these are the features that will underpin your enterprise generative AI applications. So this concludes how we are going to enable you to build truly enterprise generative applications. And again, you will learn more about these in other sessions today. I want to now talk quickly about moving things to production, going from design to production in Dataiku. This is what we call XOps, because we believe that MLOps, DataOps, and the emerging LLMOps concepts are actually facets of a more generic approach, which we call XOps, and which is really everything needs to go together. It can, because most of the applications that you will be building will not include generative AI, because generative AI does not solve all problems. And even MLOps, there are a lot of applications that do not include ML. So you need to have a unified approach to moving things to production that is not just about ML, not just about LLM, and that needs to be tightly integrated with how you design. If moving to production is a completely separate thing from designing, well, you will reach a situation where it does not go to production, and thus it doesn't bring value. Again, saying that is almost a cliche nowadays, but it's still very true. We still see too often organizations that struggle moving from experimentation to production. And that's why this XOps is such a core focus of Dataiku, a core strength of Dataiku, and something on which for which there are key capabilities in Dataiku. There is the fully CI/CD compliant deployer that allows you to have artifacts created from your design projects deployed to acceptance, to pre-production, to production in a fully traceable way. There is experiment tracking that lets you both in design and in production track metrics even when you are using full code, and it's based on MLflow, so it's based on standard experiment tracking capabilities. There is the fully automated drift monitoring capabilities that allows you to check whether your model is still receiving the same inputs as it was a few months ago, and is it still outputting the same output as it was doing a few months ago. And there are many other features. One of the important things before moving to production is ensuring that your model behaves as you think it does. So that's why there is universal feature importance for all models, even if they were not designed in Dataiku, even if they are black box models. Why we'll have full capability to both import MLflow models designed, developed outside of Dataiku, which you can import and then have all of the reporting capabilities and governance capabilities of Dataiku, but also MLflow export. Model fairness reports, which allow you to check that your model is not biased. It's not a magic bullet. It will not make your model unbiased, but it will warn you that you, as a human, need to check whether something is wrong. And finally, a more recent addition is model overrides that allow you to add business intelligence in models, letting you say, I won't let the model predict something that is impossible, that is inconsistent, and warning you that the model would have predicted something very wrong. You may need to check it. We are adding a lot of additional XOps capabilities in the coming months. I will only very quickly touch on it because very little after, you will have a dedicated session on these XOps capabilities. But basically, we are adding the ability to leverage, use, manage models that have been deployed in SageMaker, in Vertex AI, or in Azure ML. Conversely, we are adding the ability to deploy models from Dataiku to these cloud services. And with this extreme focus on openness that we are adding to our XOps capabilities, it is more and more important to have a central bird's eye view monitoring of all of your models, whether they are designed or deployed in Dataiku or outside, and this is universal monitoring. Now, at some point, you may be thinking that we care about the biggest features, the biggest things, and you may be wondering what's in for me or for you. First and foremost, Dataiku is a tool that is for you, our users. Everything we do is for the benefit of our users and is here to ensure that more people can become builders of data, that every one of you can work faster in a more efficient and more pleasant environment, and that everything that is done is trusted and can move to production. And these are just a few of the things, of the features, of the capabilities that we've done recently. And every one of these is the result of conversations that we've been having with you. So I would like to thank all of you for all of the feedback that you give, all of the information that you give. We are here for you, and we are doing more things. First of all, and of course, this is just these are just a small extracts, but we are adding a new onboarding experience to help everybody get up to speed on the platform quickly. Having production-grade data pipelines requires a good control of data quality. We already have data quality capabilities in Dataiku, but we are completely revamping them to make it easier to create data quality rules and also to have more centralized dashboards so that you can have an immediate view of the quality of all of your pipelines, all of your projects. The flow is the central part of Dataiku. It is where everything happens. It is one of the most distinctive features of Dataiku. We keep investing into always improving the flow, and we will now focus on the flow views and the flow filters so that you can focus on the parts of the flow that matter the most to you. And finally, there is something which we are working on, which is a brand new way to present insights from your data pipelines to end users. And this is something on which we are not quite ready to show it to you, but we are really very excited about that, and we really cannot wait to be able to show that to you in the coming months. But before I leave, just one more thing. I could have also put a picture of Steve Jobs, but this changed. We've talked so much about generative AI. And again, for us, when we talk about generative AI, this is really about enabling you to build your generative AI applications for your business with your data. But generative AI is also here to make you more powerful, more efficient using Dataiku. So we are working on adding Dataiku AI assistance all along the steps of the work in Dataiku. And we will be starting with AI-enhanced data preparation, with having code assistance both in code studios, so VS Code, JupyterLab, RStudio, but also Dataiku notebooks, be they Python or SQL. And finally, adding abilities to automatically explain and document the flows. And again, this is also something on which you will be able to learn more a bit later today. So stay tuned to learn more about these capabilities. And this time, thank you very much.